Antares, a startup based in Los Angeles, is pioneering the development of micro-sized nuclear reactors. These innovative reactors are designed for use not just on Earth, but also on the Moon, Mars, and beyond. They've just secured $8 million in seed funding from various venture capital funds. Initially, their vision is to offer abundant clean energy across the solar system, from Earth all the way to the asteroid belt. Before we look at the fascinating world of modular nuclear micro-reactors, let's explore how they could revolutionize space exploration. Solar panels are great for quick in-and-out missions, like touching down on the moon, often called flags and footprint missions. However, for a more permanent base with living quarters, life support systems, and even manufacturing capabilities, you need a reliable source of power that's not at the mercy of sunlight. On Mars or further out, where sunlight is dimmer and dust storms can last for months, solar panels become less practical. Modular nuclear reactors offer a game-changing solution by providing steady, maintenance-free power for years, potentially delivering 200 to 300 kilowatts per unit. That's enough to support a significant number of people. For instance, the McMurdo station in Antarctica has peak load during the summer months of 2 megawatts, and supports up to 1,200 people. 6 or 7 of these reactors could easily power a similar-sized crew in space. Now let's look at the technology Antares is using in their nuclear reactors. Let's explore the technology behind Antares R1 reactor, designed for the toughest and most remote environments. The Antares R1 is a kilowatt-class micro-reactor specifically engineered to meet the power demands of space missions. These reactors can be linked together, scaling power output from kilowatts to megawatts, with each unit capable of generating 200 to 300 kilowatts. 4 key features make this reactor stand out. First, the shielding is crucial for containing radiation safely. Antares uses tungsten and boron carbide to keep the radiation within the reactor, which also simplifies the decommissioning process. Second, heat transfer is achieved through sodium heat pipes, which work without moving parts, enhancing reliability. Imagine how difficult it would be to repair or replace parts on the Moon or Mars, especially in the middle of a dust storm, or with lunar dust all around you. Third, the reactor controls are highly automated, featuring control drums and boron carbide shutdown rods for safety and efficiency. Lastly, the core of the reactor uses HALO TRISO fuel, which stands for High Assay Low Enriched Uranium, Tri-Structural Isotropic Particle Fuel. HALO means uranium is enriched between 5 and 20% in uranium-235, higher than the 5% found in most current civilian reactors. This setup is both safe and has a high technology readiness level, indicating it's well tested and understood. Let's break down these terms. HALO makes the fuel more energy dense, allowing for longer operational cycles with less need for refueling. TRISO particles are tiny spheres with a uranium core wrapped in layers of carbon and ceramic materials, which keep the radioactive materials contained even under extreme conditions. Why use this technology? It's incredibly safe. These particles can handle very high temperatures without releasing harmful radiation, which is vital since traditional containment structures won't work in space due to weight and space constraints. For missions far from Earth, where resupplies are infrequent, this means you can have power for extended periods without needing to refuel. HALO TRISO is the perfect fuel for powering space exploration, where space and safety are at a premium. This reactor is designed for resilience, featuring passive safety measures like sodium heat pipe cooling, which doesn't rely on moving parts. Antares promises that this reactor can deliver continuous power for 3 years without any supply chain support, with all operations from control to power distribution being fully automated, ideal for the harsh conditions of the Moon or Mars. Let's look at some of the key milestones for this young startup. In March 2024, Antares tested their first sodium heat pipe. This is a key piece of technology needed for the reactor. The heat pipe is used to cool the core and route the thermal energy to a power conversion system. In the photo provided by Antares, you can see the sodium heat pipe working at full power and temperature. No moving parts, no complex ducting, and no actuation. Only the laws of physics are needed. This modular reactor is designed to be mass-produced and operated in even the most austere environments, without needing specialized operators or equipment. Heat pipes for cooling lend themselves to being mass-produced in factories, and their passive nature makes the reactor safe. In September 2024, the US Air Force awarded Antares $3.75 million to accelerate the development of their micro-reactor, designed to power critical infrastructure and capabilities both on Earth and in space. Antares believes the use of resilient, automated, and sustainable micro-reactors will provide energy resilience. That's important on Earth, but absolutely critical in space. Any interruption in power supply on the Moon, for instance, could result in loss of life support. In addition, in-situ resource utilization, or living off the land, will require large excavators, drilling equipment, and processing and manufacturing facilities, all of which require substantial power to operate. Given the Moon is without sunlight for 2 weeks every month, it's important to have alternative sources of power if humans are going to live on the Moon during the lunar nights. In October 2024, Antares received $30 million in venture capital funding. This funding will be used to expand its research and development efforts and its manufacturing capabilities to support the demonstration of its first micro-reactor. This latest funding round brings Antares' total capital raised to date to more than $38 million. The advantage of smaller reactors means less capital is needed for development and manufacturing, making it easier to secure the funding. Antares is also partnering with commercial companies in extractive industries, edge computing, and space power. The more potential customers they have, the lower the per unit cost of each reactor will be. America needs to return to iterative development of nuclear reactors through a design, build, and learn approach. Nuclear energy will increase our national security, and the same technology will enable human and industrial expansion into outer space. This is mission-critical technology, and Antares wants to become America's industrial-based partner for special-purpose micro-reactors, said Jordan Bramble, the CEO of Antares. Antares will open an R&D facility in early 2025 to support development of high-temperature heat pipes and graphite machining. Their design approach involves rapidly building and testing electrically heated demonstration units, or EDUs, to validate their simulations. They are building their first 240 kilowatt thermal EDU, scheduled to turn on by mid-2025. Okay, let's go on to upcoming events. Antares are working on their first EDU, or electrically heated demonstration unit, for mid-2025. This will be a 240 kilowatt system. We'll keep you informed on this startup, as energy generation is critical for exploring other worlds. Okay, that's it for this video. Be sure to like and subscribe so you'll see our upcoming videos. We make videos every week covering the space industry, with an emphasis on the smaller space startups that aren't covered so well on other channels. See you soon.